I'm going to tell you how to get better grades in school with this one tip. So keep watching. Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. I know schools are starting to open, so I wanted to make this video to give those of you in school one extremely useful tip on how to get good grades and maintain them. I feel when I was in school, keeping this one thing in mind helped me to get good grades as well as maintain them throughout the year. Ready? That tip is to focus on doing well at the beginning of the semester or year, depending on how your classes are structured. So keep this in mind depending on whether you're in college, high school, or even if you're younger than that. So now you might be wondering, that's all? I watched this video for this? Well, let me tell you why this is crucial and why so many people forget this. So in most schools, at least here in the United States, your GPA is calculated by averaging all the grades you received throughout the year or semester from different assignments or criteria the class is set, like exams, projects, or attendance. So now that being said, school is also the easiest at the beginning of the semester or year because this is when you'll be doing a lot of things like syllabus review. You start with the basics of the class, and so on. I know for me, a lot of the assignments I would get in the beginning of the year would be to write something to introduce myself. So, you know, easy enough. Exams towards the beginning of the year are also easier because they cover less topics since the class just started. You just don't have that many topics that you've covered. I think you guys can understand where I'm going with this. There are a lot of easy points to grab at the beginning of the semester or year. And as the semester progresses, the assignments and exams just get harder because you cover more topics. So if you can manage to not miss anything and score as high as possible in the beginning of the semester or the year, then in theory, it'll keep your GPA high just because of how the GPA is calculated. Of course, this doesn't mean you should not care about your grades later on in the semester, because if you flunk everything else, then your GPA is still not going to look good. And for the most part, classes tend to get more difficult as it progresses, either because the material itself is harder to comprehend, or there's just more stuff to memorize. So unless you're a genius, this is hard for most people, and we spend hours studying. And even then, not everyone can do well, as they would like. So by doing well in the beginning of the semester, this would keep your GPA up, especially if your grades start to slip towards the end of the semester. Easy enough, right? You might be saying to yourself, sure, I can do that, no problem. But here's where I feel a lot of people mess up or forget. So at the beginning of the semester, everyone is coming back from a long break, whether it's a summer vacation or a winter vacation. And they're either still in vacation mode or they want to get together with all the friends that they haven't seen in a while. And while there's nothing wrong with that, it usually comes at the expense of the schoolwork. A lot of people feel the material in the beginning of the semester is not significant, so they can afford to miss it. However, by doing that, you're missing out on some easy points that'll help your GPA in the future. So now, I understand that if you only care about like what you're learning, and you want to make sure that what you're learning is something that you're interested in, then you don't really care about your grades, then this might not apply to you. However, for those of you who do care about the number that you see on your transcript, then I feel this would be great, of great use to you. And this applies for those of you, especially who need to present your GPAs for internships, jobs, and especially if you're applying for further education, like graduate school or something like that. So now, I hope you had a chance. I hope you have a chance to put what I discussed here to use and be able to improve your GPA this new school year. So, you know, let me know in the comments below if this ended up working for you or not. I'm really interested to know how that applies for everyone else. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up down below and subscribe to my channel. And more content's coming soon. Really appreciate everyone for tuning in. Until next time.